in the well. Don't ask me, I'll never tell. I looked to you as it fell, and now you're in my way. I traded my soul for a wish, pennies and dimes for a kiss. I wasn't looking for this, but now you're in my way. Your stare was holding, ripped jeans, skin was showing. Hot night wind was blowing. Where you think you're going, baby? Hey, I just met you.
Started freaking out. So I got you guys to completely come in and fix this issue because I need our tips back into the restaurant.
You do realize we're not detectives, we just make documentaries.
Well, get a detective over! Why did I get the whole entire team here if I don't get my own tips back into my job?
Literally came into work, normal as anything. I looked to the tip jar and there was literally nothing there. I'd worked the late shift, so it couldn't be me.
If you did work the late shift, didn't that mean you're the last person with the tip jar?
But it was empty.
In the morning.
Action.
Oh, sorry.
It's okay.
Do you guys want to...
Action.
I know it seems crowded, but I got my last drink about 40 minutes ago.
That's all?
Let me get you yours. It'll make me feel less bad about getting a Coke for myself.
You don't drink?
Ever since I shat myself at my sister's wedding 11 years ago.
Okay, thank you.
No, I'll get this.
No, that's alright.
Don't make me fight a stranger.
I am all in a sea of wonders. I doubt, I fear, I think strange things which I dare not confess to my own soul. Before me stood a tall man, clean-shaven and clad in black. I protested, but he insisted. Nay, sir, you are my guest. Let me see to your comfort myself. As the Count leaned over me and his hand touched me, I could not repress a shudder. I am glad you found your way here. Welcome to my house. Enter freely. Go safely and leave something of the happiness you bring.
Okay, so basically in class today we did animation with Jonah at the very start of the day, and that was, we learned about tweening and in between frames for animations and how important transitions are, and we also learned about, you know, different but whole like old kind of form of animation, like with the papers, like flipping the papers. I think transformation and transition is really important in animation for me anyways, because it really helps you get your story or your visuals from A to B smoothly. And it can also be a really creative way to not have your stuff look blocky. And it's just fun to animate as well. Like, I love animating fucking, I love tweening. In between frames are one of my favorite parts. But we also did a lot of improv with our lecturer, the second half, I can't remember her name. But that was really fun as well. It was a lot of improv and kind of like, we learned a lot about liminal spaces.
Okay, storyboarding with Nick in the morning. That was good. That was easy for me because I'm doing animation and I've been doing storyboarding anyways. I've been practicing that. Second was filmmaking with Jonah. We did that. We basically did a little mockumentary about who was in the restaurant, who stole the tip jar. It was really fun. I really enjoyed it. I need to get better at video editing, but that's it. And thirdly, we did Helen's class, where we talked about colors' meanings, like the meaning of things, yada yada. I need to focus on that more. I'm really bad at that. I know, like, red is anger, green is jealousy, blue is sadness, yellow is happiness, but other than that, I need to work on tuning in my brain to the colors and yada yada. I had a good week.
What did I do today? We are in a film studio, as you can see. We recorded a film with like proper equipment. That's pretty cool.
We're doing our vlogs.
Yeah, we're doing our vlogs.
Oh shit, sorry.
What's important about set design? Only thing I learned today was that lighting is super important. And that these rooms are way bigger than I thought. And that all the equipment.
Oh, is this a TikTok?
All the equipment.
I've heard so much about them.
All the equipment is super expensive. Okay, this is my vlog on my personal journey as a storyboard artist and sound recorder in the collaborative production group or task. So my roles were storyboard artist and sound recorder. I am an animation student, so storyboarding was a little bit more down my lane, and sound recording was fun because I haven't done any of that before. So here I have one of the animatics that I had created for one of our key intro scenes. Basically, we had this whole vibe of like the mysterious guy with his arm, you know, we're gonna like see who it is at the end of the thing, hopefully. I hope my group was able to, you know, read that clearly, and I hope it was helpful in the production. I've also got some key, like, some, what are they called?
early like concept designs for like what kind of vibe we were going for. I've got some in the sketchbook as well. These will all be sent, obviously. So these were, you know, a few concept designs for the couples. Here you can see some, here you can see some of my storyboards. I was struggling on kind of, one thing I struggled on for storyboards was official kind of frames, like the frame sizes, and not frame sizes, obviously, the screen sizes, and how to officially lay out a storyboard. I'm not sure if there's an official structure or not, but I hope my team was able to read them properly. And sound recording, I've got, basically what we did was we couldn't hire out any of equipment, so we had a Yeti mic strapped to, sellotaped to a long wooden pole, and a laptop connected to the Yeti mic. So I was holding the laptop in one hand and a Yeti mic in the other. That was a really fun experience, and I hope I can, you know, get to do that again, because I'm doing animation next year and I don't want my entire foundation, obviously, to be geared entirely towards animation. I want to kind of branch out and explore different areas of film. But other than that, I had a good time storyboarding. I wish that I wish we started production, like early production, as in like concept, you know, stuff that, like what we were thinking for the film earlier, because I ended up having to storyboard quite late into, you know, the time frame that we were, should have been storyboarding, because I couldn't get a shot list from our director. But that's all okay. And in the end, a lot of my storyboards weren't, I don't think they were used, but we kind of like ended up going a little off script on the day of filming, which happens, but I really enjoyed it and I cannot wait to do it again. Thanks.
So this week we were doing a 2-week Dracula project. I was super excited for it because I really liked the book. We read it over Christmas and I thought it was like, I didn't know it was from an Irish author, which is really cool, by the way. I don't really hear much about Irish authors. Anyways, I was in a small group of four, which was challenging enough in itself. We had too many jobs for people who were taking on maybe too much stuff. But then we also had a problem with distributing jobs equally, and some people not taking on as much jobs as they should. I also had a bit of a lack of commitment in the project, sadly, because I had a rough week and kind of prioritized my job the past few weeks over university, which can't really, it's not sustainable. I need to stop doing that. But I'll work on it really hard. And I was really excited about this movie that our group had come up with. It was gonna be like a short little music video. So I helped out. We had a meeting, I think, straight afterwards, where we got our shot list together. Someone wasn't present, but it was me, Tori, and Ivan. And we were able to get most of our shot lists together by then. And also by then we had written the script and already gotten my audio done for the movie, which was really great, fast progress. I was super happy with it. And then we kind of hit a wall when it came to filming, because my job was supposed to be actor for Jonathan. And then we had our camera operator wasn't available a lot that week. So it was kind of like, we live very far away from each other and we struggled communicating on places to meet up. And I also didn't have a lot of free time, but I tried to film as many shots as I could on my own, but my mistakes. And it's ended up during my editing, when I was editing it, I was super excited to edit, by the way. I just got a new editing app and I wanted to try it out. But during that, it had come to my attention that they had already edited the film without my knowledge. And I was kind of like, oh, that's nice, you know, okay. I was a little bummed out because I really wanted to edit it and I had already gotten the movie edited. But theirs turned out better than mine anyways. So I've got to work on the editing department myself. But so I was meant to be an actor. I was voice acting the entire thing. I helped out with script and the shot list, and I edited a version of the movie. I wasn't present on class to present because of reasons, and I regret that. I wish I was there. But that was Dracula.